And we're now joined by Davao del Norte First District Representative and former House Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez. Representative Alvarez, good morning to you.
Hi, Karen. Good morning.
All right. Well, a happy new year to you. It's been a while since you've been on Head Start. Okay, so you have always led the change for the charter. When you were House Speaker, you were the lead convener, you wanted federalism, and now it seems you're singing a different tune. You are not in favor of charter change today. What changed?
That is correct, Karen. No? I was one of the movers to amend the Constitution and change the form of government from a unitary to a federal form of government. That was under the leadership of former President Rodrigo Duterte. Magkaiba ka rin eh. Noong panahon ni PRRD, ang specific instructions niya was to follow the law, yung proseso, constitution. So there are, as we all know, there are three modes of amending a constitution. First is the constitutional convention. Second is constituent assembly. And third is the people's initiative. Now, iba yung panahon ni Duterte dahil bumuo pa siya ng isang constitutional commission kung saan ito ay headed by former Chief Justice Renato Puno. And yung mga members noon, lahat ano eh, yung may credibility. One was Attorney Ruben Canoy of Cagayan de Oro. The other one was Dean Julio T. Hanqui, July T. Hanqui. Yung isa naman si Jonathan Malaya. Yung isa si Professor Ed Tayaw. Maganda. Inaral mabuti yung amendments. And they presented a draft of the Constitution. Malinaw, walang tinatago.
Okay, but what makes you say that this particular, I would say the movers or members of Congress aren't following the law? You cited three modes. During the time of Duterte, he formed a commission in effect, a group, and it was gearing towards a con-con. But today, there is a people's initiative supposedly coming from a private group, and then with the economic provisions, there's a possibility that it's a constituent assembly. So when you look at all the modes, they're all in the Constitution. What makes this illegal? Why are you saying they're not following the law?
Hey, maganda ito, Karen, no, kung sincere lahat. Let's say itong People's Initiative. Mm. Eh, nakikita ko rito, hindi naman to People's Initiative, hindi ito PI. PI, di ba? People's Initiative, hindi. TI ito, TI.
What is that?
Tambaluslos Initiative.
So are you referring to specifically who? Be specific, sir.
Alam mo, Karen, kilala natin, no? Lahat yan may ambisyon maging presidente. Ang problema, kahit sa survey ng senatorial balls, kulelat.
Okay, no. All right. Now, we're a news program, so let's be specific. I'll ask you, are you referring to the Speaker of the House?
Yes.
Okay, so you used the term tambaluslos. That was a similar term used by Vice President Sara Duterte, referring to an unnamed person, right? Are you and Vice President Sara Duterte now allies? I want to ask you first directly, are you and the Vice President now allies?
We have not talked yet, no? Pero Karen, if you will ask me if I will support her, categorically, yes, I will support her. For one reason, she is from Mindanao. No matter what happens, her heart still a Mindanao.
All right. Okay. So let's move forward. So you say you haven't spoken, but will you will support the vice president? So Do you believe then what you were saying is the people's initiative? Is it a people's initiative? And you believe it is instigated by the speaker? Is this it?
Yes, I believe so.
Okay, but what proof do you have of that? It's been denied over and over by the majority, and even Representative Erwin Tulfo has come to the show and said the speaker doesn't have anything to do with this people's initiative. How do you know, Representative, that the speaker is behind the people's initiative?
Karen, I cannot see the importance of changing the constitution now. They say for economic reasons. I don't know at whose interest. Is it the people's interest or somebody else's interest? Mas maraming problema ang hinahanap ng bansa ngayon. Yung problema lang natin sa...
Isn't that the same complaint, frankly, that people had during Duterte's time? When the constitution was being reviewed and you were pushing for the constitution, didn't critics also tell you, Speaker, bakit yan ang inaatupag nyo? Eh, ang daming problema ng Pilipinas. Kumbaga, hindi lang po ba pareho lang? Different administration, yes. Same complaint.
Yes, but President Duterte then, listen to the people. Sabi ng mga tao, marami pang problema dapat sa kasuhin. Nakinig siya. Sinabi niya sa amin, oh, medyo tigil niyo muna yan. Unahin muna natin yung problema na hinaharap ng bansa.
Okay. And what do you believe? You're saying President Marcos Jr. isn't listening? Is that it?
Hindi ko pa masabi yan, Karen, no? Kasi hindi pa naman niya... Nag-uumpisa pa lang yung ano eh, yung laban. Malay mo, merong makapag-advise sa kanya ng tama at nakinig siya at tumigil lahat ng to.
Okay, now President Marcos Jr. supposedly intervened during a discussion between Speaker Romualdez and Senate President Zubiri, and he has already ordered, in effect, that the Senate take the lead when it comes to amending the economic provisions of the charter. And Senator Sonny Angara has been assigned to head that particular committee. So number one, this is very different. This isn't changing the form of government to federalism. This is supposedly just changing the economic provisions. Sang-ayon po ba kayo na baguhin lang po ang economic provisions?
Hindi mo masasabi yan, Karen. Ito, masinaryo tayo. Halimbawa, kinonvene nila ang Congress into a constituent assembly. Now, what will stop the congressmen from telling the senators, ito ang gusto namin. Hindi lang yung ano, hindi lang yung economic provisions, ito gusto namin. We want to change the form of government. Now, anong magagawa ng senador? All we have to do is to comply the words of the Constitution, which says 3/4 votes of all its members. Hindi naman sinasabing voting separately or jointly. Wala yun.
Although I think they've agreed that if they do, if they convene as a constituent assembly, it seems that they've agreed it will be separate voting.
Baka mabudol-budol sila dyan.
Naniniwala kayo? Maloloko ang Senado?
Oo, naniniwala ako. Ang tawag dyan sa Kongreso, sagasa. Sasagasaan nila yan. Ngayon, pagising ng mga senador, burado na sila, erase na sila sa picture. Anong recourse? Supreme Court. Tatakbo sila Supreme Court.
Okay. Now, Representative, because I've interviewed you for many years, so I'm familiar with York History, right, on Head Start. I'm curious, what is your relationship now with former President Duterte? Have you made peace? Have you spoken with each other already?
We're still friends, Captain.
Okay, but have you met? I mean, from the time that you left, when you were ousted as Speaker, I know that you had not been in, even when you won, frankly, in your district, you did beat technically the candidates of the former president there. So technically you kind of ran against him, right? So what is your relationship today?
We're okay, Kevin.
So you've made peace? Nagbati na po kayo?
Opo. I don't hold grudges. Travel light lang ko, Karen. At my age, travel light lang talaga.
Okay, so you've made peace. You've spoken to each other. Is this correct?
Yes, yes. That's all right. True.
The reason I'm asking this, sir, is would you still have this same conviction if you and the former president were at odds with each other? I mean, here you are, you speak against charter change, but you led charter change when you were speaker. So some might ask, what's the credibility or the interest of Representative Alvarez singing a different tune today? Some may criticize you as not being consistent with your own political values and convictions.
Karen, I'm still consistent with my political values and convictions. I want to change the charter, but not this way. Hindi yung economic provisions lang, hindi. Revise the entire constitution if you want.
Okay. You mean to say you want a revision, including the form of government? That's what you want?
Okay. Through a constitutional convention.
So you want CONCON. Now, my next question. Would you be able to trust the leadership of Congress today for a change in the charter? Under the leadership of President Marcos Jr., would you support that?
No.
Bakit po hindi? Naniniwala kayo ibaba ang motibo ng liderato ng Kongreso ngayon?
Ito, Karen, no? Paano ako respeto ngayon sa speaker? He cannot even protect the interest of the congressman.
How? What do you mean?
Pag speaker ka, the least that you can do is to protect the net. Ngayon, anong ginagawa nila? 2023, they canceled major infrastructure projects in different districts, buong bansa. Even in my district, ang daming major infrastructure projects, pinrogram ang DPWH, kinansel nila. And then yung pera pupunta doon sa unprogram. Kaya nagbalon yung unprogram. And you know unprogram ba? Lump sum yan, lump sum amount, ibig sabihin pork barrel yan. Lumalaki ng lumalaki. 2023, 800 million mahigit. 2024, 1.5 billion.
Pero paano ililipat?
Pinabaha nga kami.
Oh, matanong ko lang, no? Okay, just quickly on this. What makes you certain that the funding, I mean, you have a point with the projects for your district, but what makes you certain that it was moved, transferred to unprogrammed funds when the essence of an unprogrammed fund is it doesn't have any funding? Diba yun po ang essence niya? Parang makokolekta pa lang, titignan kung may sobra, kaya siya unprogrammed. Paano kayo nakakasiguro? Dun nilipat yun. Then that would be programmed.
Kasi pag nag-cancel ka ng project, saan pupunta yung amount na allotted dapat? Doon sa unprogrammed yun. Ang unprogrammed, tama ka doon. Unfunded at kinakailangan punduhan yun ng mga yung mga bagong revenues no, na pumapasok sa
Yung sobra.
Sobra.
So paano niyo alam na tinanggalan kayo tapos nalipat doon? Paano niyo alam kung nalipat?
Kasi walang ibang pupuntahan ka rin. Saan pupunta yun? Kaya lumubo yung unprogram eh. Pag nag-cancel sila ng project dito, automatic yung pera na yun pupunta sa unprogram yun.
Okay. My next question is, do you believe your project, the funding for your project, was essentially removed because you are not an ally of the speaker? Were you the only one, or were there other members as well who were either not part of the speaker's supermajority?
Meron din karen ng mga hindi part ng supermajority na natanggalan.
So naniniwala kayo you were sinadya po ito?
Yes.
Because you are not perceived as an ally?
Yes, that's correct.
And how many of you feel this way? Or have this issue?
Marami dyan. They're just quiet.
Okay, all right. So did you ever speak with the speaker on the projects for your constituents? Were you able to speak with him?
Yes, last year.
And what happened?
Nothing.
Okay, so in a way, ang tanong ko ngayon is, are you against the move of the speaker, or let's not put it, are you against the move of the supermajority for charter change because of what happened to your district? Is this a personal vengeance on your end?
No. I just can't support a move na hindi klaro if it is for the people or just for one person.
Ano po ba ang pangamba ninyo? Sa totoo lang, sa charter change na ito, I believe that you've called this a self-serving farce. You've said this in one of your statements. What do you believe is the intention and the motivation of this administration or Congress for charter change? Anong nakikita niyong nais nilang mangyari?
Ang nakikita ko dyan, Karen, alam naman natin itong speaker gusto maging Pangulo ng Pilipinas. Under the present setup, mahirap eh. You know, to run for president, you must be oozing with charisma. Eh, ito, yung charisma, parang Supreme Court.
Alright, but you're saying he's not popular enough to win? Is that what you're saying?
Parang Supreme Court, walang appeal. Walang ka-appeal. Paano ka manalo?
So what's the point? You're saying that the charter change is meant to perpetuate him in power? Be specific. What do you mean?
Palitan yung form of government from presidential to parliamentary. Then maybe he will run for prime minister. That's the only chance for him to lead the country.
So you believe that's the intention? That's the motivation?
Yes, for me that's very clear.
All right, okay. So you've made your point, you won't support it, you believe this administration has other motivations for changing the charter. Now, Senate President Zubiri said he would resign if ever napasok ang mga political amendments. Your thoughts on that?
That's a very dangerous statement, Karen. Baka mapahapak sa dyan.
Dahil,
talagang hindi mangyayari yung kung ano na pag-usapan nila sa susunod. I don't think so.
So you're saying Congress can't be trusted, essentially?
The leadership.
Can't be trusted. Is that it?
Not Congress as a whole, dahil marami pa rin mga members ng Congress yung ano, yung merong word of honor. Pero ito, kung leadership kasi walang word of honor, mahirap yun.
Okay, before we go, I don't want to leave without at least discussing the gravity of the flooding situation in Davao del Norte. Kasi malinaw, no? Kabilang sa sama ng loob nyo ay tinanggalan ng pondo ang distrito for projects that would have helped prevent flooding in the future. What is the situation right now as we speak?
At we speak, Karen, huminto na yung ulan. No, kaya huminto na rin yung operations namin para sa pagbigay ng mga foodstuffs, pagkain sa mga tao na gugutom. Itong flooding ng Davao del Norte, isang major cause dito yung siltation ng rivers. Yung mga outflow ng drainage. Tapos may mga pinrogram ng DPWH na dikes to prevent flooding. Na-cancel din yun, kasama yun sa mga na-cancel na major.
Kahit yung pondo sa DPWH tinanggal?
Tinanggal. At alam natin, Karen, ha? Pag DPWH ng program ng infrastructure projects, that is with consultation with the Regional Development Council.
Okay, now the flooding right now, okay, can we show footage and photos? So you have severe flooding in 6 towns, 2 cities because of intermittent rains that's been going on right now in Mindanao. You're under a state of calamity at this point. May pera pa ba sa distrito ninyo?
DPWH, wala.
Wala. So do you believe that your province, your constituents are being penalized because, let's face it, dahil Davao kayo, this is the, in effect, ito ang probinsya ng dating Pangulo. Are you seeing a political hand in this?
Karen, honestly, I do not want to think it that way. No? Sana hindi naman ganun. Dahil, siyempre, kawawa naman yung mga tao. Bumuto rin naman yung mga tao. Nanalo yung Pangulo dito sa Davao region.
All right. So I think when it comes to the flooding, what is your message? May panawagan ba kayo kay Pangulong Bongbong Marcos Jr.? Because with the flooding, it's your constituents that are affected. The Filipino people in Davao del Norte.
Well, Karen, ang panawagan mo lang dito sana ay maging concern naman yung Pangulo, tignan niya yung mga kinansel ng mga infrastructure projects na pinrogram ng DPWH, yung mga para sa tao. Gaya halimbawa, itong to prevent flooding, eh dapat naman wag naman cancelin. At yung assistance doon sa mga na baha. Kaso nga dito, merong namigay ng assistance. Kasagsagan ng baha. Kaya lang pinipili lang nila yung mga political leaders.
Sino? Ito, Sino namigay ng assistance nung baha
Tingog at na party list? Tingog party list. Dinaan nila sa AIX. Ang AIX, assistance to individuals in crisis situation. Kaya lang, ang nangyayari, pinipili kung sino yung mga leaders ng mga political opponents namin dito, yun yung namimigay. Pinipili lang nila yung mga binibigyan. Huwag naman sana ganun.
All right. Now to end, are you seeing that eventually this ends up to be a Romualdez Duterte war in the upcoming elections? Are you seeing that?
Hindi ako masyadong takot dyan, pare. Mas natatakot ako yung nangyayari sa West Philippine Sea. Mahirap yun, Karen. Halimbawa, this is not a question of patriotism. This is a question of madness. Paano ka naman makipag-away sa China doon? Isipin mo, isusugo mo yung coast guards natin doon. They are military. They will be massacred worse than Mama Sapano.
All right, so wait, what you're saying, okay, this is a whole other topic altogether. So you have to forgive me. We don't have time for this one. But what you're saying is you don't agree with the foreign policy of President Marcos Jr., right?
Definitely,
that's
definitely.
What your point. Okay,
yes.
But that's a whole other topic. Okay, but at the end of the day, your issue is you will not support charter change. You believe this administration, the leadership of Congress, has other motivations. It's to perpetuate himself in power. That's what you believe.
Yes.
Okay, all right. And in effect, mahirap lang natanggalan ng probinsya ninyo, yung distrito nyo, ng pondo for the projects you need to prevent flooding.
That is correct.
Okay. All right. But is it right to say you're allies now with the Dutertes again, both the former president and Sara? Is it with you and Sara, everything's forgotten?
I have not talked to the vice president, but the former president Duterte, nag-usap po kami.
And what did you tell him? I'll support your daughter? What did you say?
Hindi naman specifically ganun grabe, but sabi ko lang sa kanya na, you know, at the rate we are going now, yung bansa, no? Yung mga problema na nakaharap sa bansa, ay kinakailangan, magkaisa din kami.
Okay. All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today. It's always interesting to speak with you. Thank you so much for joining me today, Representative Pantaleon Alvarez. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Karen.